So with you know, COVID emerging, and as a result of it, we had a global lockdown. Many industries around, like, they were trying to maintain the existing functionality at a very reduced cost, and cloud actually helped them to achieve that, right? So with that happening, without like proper due diligence, there were a lot of, you know, movement from on-premise to, you know, kind of cloud. And now as the world resumes, now they are focusing on to improve the security. And that's why, you know, at a global level, we are having a lot of emphasis on, you know, we already have existing footprints in cloud, and they want to enhance it or improve it at any cost. So that's where, like, cloud security is playing a very important role, you know, not just across, you know, IT sector, but across the world, actually. Most of us are not from cloud background, right? So we are not working on a cloud, you know, day in and day out, right? So we may be a network engineer, we may be you know, someone who's working in, you know, a DevOps or database administrator. So if you want to learn cloud, right, it is not going to be we are all like looking for one course which can actually transform us into a cloud, you know, expert, right? So we all look for those kind of options. And even if you take from an, you know, a technical standpoint, so if you take like ISO 17789, which is, you know, cloud computing reference architecture, they talk about four viewpoints, right? So user viewpoint, functional, implementation, and deployment. Most of the certifications that we currently have in the market, they are just talking about only the user view and the functional view, right? So when it comes to implementation and deployment, generally they say like it is left with the hands of the cloud service provider. So cloud service provider will take care of it. And we don't get an opportunity to learn about the implementation and deployment with the existing certification so far. But if you take like CCSE, Certified Cloud Security Engineer by EC Council, it is actually covering all those four viewpoints. It talks about the user and functional viewpoint, as well as it talks about the implementation and deployment. So you can learn about like how the major cloud service providers like Azure, AWS, GCP, they all like how we can actually implement it or enhance it. So if you're like looking for one course which will convert you from a zero to hero in cloud or cloud security, I would strongly recommend EC Council's Certified Cloud Security Engineer. I find like all the modules are very much relevant to the current scenario. However, like to give more emphasis, like you can take like, you know, the penetration testing and cloud forensics. So which are like not, you know, we would get an opportunity to learn on a day in and day out. So when you consider, as I mentioned, like if you want to become a zero to hero in cloud or cloud security, I think these 50 plus modules are basically the differentiator here. So you will get exposed to all the different cloud service providers. So even if you work on one particular cloud also, now you'll get an opportunity to learn how, you know, the other cloud service provider is offering the same kind of functionality to, you know, understand the differences. These labs will be helpful. And as a hot tip, what I can say is whenever you're doing the lab, try to do it twice, actually. So for the first time, your focus will be only on like getting that output, right? Making that test case or the lab exercise successful. But during the second time, you'll actually understand why you are actually doing it. So the first would be more like how to achieve it. But the second time when you practice, you will understand why we actually do that or what exactly is the objective of it. So yes, we have 50 plus labs, but my advice is to like do it twice so that you'll be very, it will be very helpful in the real time scenarios. Yes, I would suggest, because like we are exposed to all the different cloud services in at the same time, so that we can easily correlate and understand. And also, like if CCSE is going to be your first certificate, so once you have completed all these labs, now you can, you know, go to those individual, you know, certifications like AWS security or Azure security, and you will be able to easily, you know, clear that out. So it helps you, you know, understand individual clouds, as well as it helps you to build an overall like cloud security portion. I would say yes. So whatever like currently like AWS or Azure, they follow the security methodology, the same kind of methodology is taught over here. So the screens or the UI may change every time, but the core concepts will still remain the same, right? And since CCSE is a very latest course, so they have almost captured the latest, you know, UI possible, so that it is very much relevant or like similar to the current environment scenarios. Yes, it is actually delivering, you know, value to us. So like as I mentioned, like we may not come from a cloud background. Most of us may not come from an actual cloud background when we are actually taking up these courses, right? So like we may be a network engineer or a database administrator, right? And by going through these modules and by doing these lab exercises, we can get an end-to-end, you know, like cloud security options that are available and that are available at our disposal also. So this course is basically delivering a lot of value in transforming your journey in the to launch your journey in the cloud security. The recognition was huge. So whenever there is a opportunity with respect to multi-cloud or like where like multiple cloud providers are involved, so I would be kind of the default person to be called in, because you know I have a basic knowledge of all these basic cloud service providers functionality, and that knowledge actually like gave me a lot of recognition in getting those opportunities or grabbing those opportunities.